Alright, so Lizard Man here with the leg WOD, showing off my homemade cinder setup, and I'm going to take a quick walk by it and then jump through it so that you can see what I'm doing. Combination of distance, height and distance. So it's a pretty tough setup I have there. That's going uphill. Going downhill is a bit easier.
Spot jumps,
which are going to be bad news, so feel free to laugh, because it's going to be quite tough. I'm just not even going to get anything out of those last six. So we're going to go straight to depth jumps. Again, part of these is all about scaling. Doing what you can do and not trying to do what you can't do.
As you can see, this is at or above my hips.
Oh, I actually know how high that is.
Remember, when you're doing your depth jumps, I built up this retaining wall. I didn't build the wall, but I started going higher and higher. I don't want to just start really high. And now I'm jumping off of this. This isn't enough for me. So, easy. Nice, simple landing. I prefer doing these more barefoot, but I didn't bring those shoes with me today, so that was my bad. But I absolutely do use my side fingers. You can get used to that. I'm 230 pounds, well, usually, 221 today, so I'm a little light, but I haven't been eating, and I haven't been drinking enough, so I'd be expected that I'm down probably 5 pounds. Notice how I'm able to catch my weight by that 45 degree. That's what you want. If you're going all the way to here, you don't have the strength to be dealing with that height of a drop. And at first, don't jump off of something that big, just step. And then, obviously I don't have any more height to deal with, so I have to just start jumping to get that extra height. All right, that's my first round. All right, round two. Again, I'm probably only gonna do 30 seconds of the shuttle runs. My conditioning's just not that good yet.
Tired, your center's gonna get harder.
So don't expect to be able to do the same thing, especially coming uphill like that. It's brutal. Way harder. And it's not that much of a hill. Remember, once you feel that explosion start to leave your body, don't waste your time with any more squat jumps, because you're no longer getting that explosive benefit out of it. Notice how I'm not stuttering on my landing. Can't stick it. Trying to survive. If you're doing it right, you're going to feel it in your glutes and your hamstrings more than your calves. I went a little low there. Don't do that. That rep before was just me not paying attention and going too low. As you can tell, I can absorb that shock within that range of motion. Which means that I'll probably do this height for another month and then add half a foot to a foot. You gotta remember that acceleration's not linear. Every extra foot you have of a drop is acceleration. It's not just, it's building on your speed. It's not a steady increase. It goes in a curve. It's kind of weird. The gravity's pretty serious business. And when you're 230 pounds, 220, whatever, you gotta take it slow. Zip around two. All right, round three. Notice how between rounds and between reps, I alternate the foot I'm out with. Every so often, make sure I'm not favoring any one side.
Yeah.
I'd like to point out that it may look like I'm stuttering. I'm not. I'm in complete control. Point this out. I'm going to do a higher jump. Stick. So taking a step forward does not mean I'm controlling my body weight and completely stopping momentum first. Make sure you do the same.
That's round three. All right, as you can tell, I've lengthened my centers by one obstacle and about 7 feet in length. So I think I'm going to do this first before my shuttle runs and go uphill because I want to get a little more explosion. And we'll see if I can do this in one go. I feel like I'm going to puke. Time for depth jumps. This is the end. Left is 2 30-second sets of weighted pike stretch.